Action 17, Vaisampayana said, Thus insulted by the Sutta's son, but illustrious princess, the beautiful Krishna, eagerly wishing for the destruction of Virata's journal, went to her quarters, and Drupada's daughter of dark hue and splendor raised then performed her ablutions, and washing her body and clothes with water, Krishna began to ponder weepingly on the means of dispelling her grief. And she reflected, saying, What am I to do? Whither shall I go? How can my purpose be effected? And while she was thinking thus, she remembered Bhima and said to herself, There is none else save Bhima that can today accomplish the purpose on which my heart is set. And afflicted with great grief, the large-eyed and intelligent Krishna, possessed of powerful protectors, then rose up at night and, leaving her bed speedily, proceeded towards the quarters of Bhimasena, desirous of beholding her lord. And possessed of great intelligence, the daughter of Drupada entered her husband's quarters, saying, How canst thou sleep while that wretched commander of Virata's forces, who is my foe, yet liveth, having perpetrated today that foul act? Vaisampayana continued, Then the chamber where Bhima slept, breathing hard like a lion, being filled with the beauty of Draupadi, Drupada's daughter, and of the high-souled Bhima, blazed forth in splendor. And Krishna, of sweet smiles, finding Bhimasena in the cooking apartments, approached him with the eagerness of a three-year-old cow brought up in the woods, approaching a powerful bull in her first season, or of a she-crane living by the waterside, approaching her mate in the pairing season. And the princess of Panchala embraced the second son of Pandu, even as a creeper embraces a huge and mighty sala on the banks of the Gomati, and embracing him with her arms. Krishna, of faultless features, awaked him as a lioness awaketh a sleeping lion in a trackless forest, and embracing Bhimasena, even as a she-elephant embraceth her mighty mate, the faultless Panchali addressed him in voice sweet as the sound of a stringed instrument, emitting Gandhara note. And she said, Arise, arise, why dost thou, O Bhimasena, lie down as one dead? Surely he that is not dead never suffereth a wicked wretch that hath disgraced his wife to live. And awakened by the princess, Bhima of mighty arms then rose up and sat upon his couch overlaid with a rich bed, and he was of the Kuru race. Then addressed the princess, his beloved wife, saying, For what purpose hast thou come hither in such a hurry? Thy color is gone, and thou lookest lean and pale. Tell me everything in detail. I must know the truth, whether it be pleasurable or painful, agreeable or disagreeable. Tell me all. Having heard everything, I shall apply the remedy. I alone, O Krishna, am entitled to thy confidence in all things, for it is I who deliver thee from perils again and again. Tell me quickly, what is thy wish, and what is the purpose that is in thy view? And return thou to thy bed before others awake. Thus ends the 17th section in the Kichakabhada Parva of the Virata Parva.